On land, all of the Earth's monsters have been collected and are living together in a place called Monsterland.
Look! You fools! You're in danger! They're here already! You're next!
The views and opinions expressed do not necessarily reflect those of Access for Wayne, the Allen County Public Library, or any other supporting groups.
Take your stinking paws off me, you damn dirty ape!
If you'd like to produce a show, call us at 260-421-1250.
You're next! You're next! You're next!
I see we have guests. Good evening, my children of the grave. I bid you welcome to the Haunted Hotel. Allow me to introduce myself. I am the night manager and your host of horror, Mr. Graves. Thank you for spending your night with us. Let me call the Bell Beast to arrange your things. And tomb. 13. Now, while Fang busies himself making your tomb livable, come and join us for tonight's Dead Time story. This evening's tale is Gorgo, starring Bill Travers and William Sylvester. The operators of a salvage vessel come upon a prehistoric creature that has been unleashed from its subterranean lair by an underwater earthquake. They decide to capture the creature and then take it to London to put on display in a circus. But will they be able to keep the beast contained? Let's find out. It's now time for you to pull up a tombstone, crawl under your graze blanket, and snuggle close to your ghoul friend while I turn down the lights and tell you the tale, Gorgo.
terribly ugly. The men are getting edgy.
Yeah, so am I.
Come on, Joe, make it snappy, will you? Come on, get out of here.
Wait a minute, Sam. There's thousands of dollars worth of stuff in that old rust bucket. I'm not getting out of here without it.
Are you kidding?
Stop worrying. Take it out and be back up in 10 minutes.
I know these waters well, Sam. I've never seen the like of this before. Get me a lug. I'm going down to get him.
He's come up!
As I thought, Joe.
How long to get her into shape?
Rudder stock's bent. A couple of sprung plates.
Uh-huh.
That mess on deck, 3 or 4 days. And we're out of fresh water.
Let's go ashore and see what they've got, eh, sir? There. I've never seen anything like that before. The whole ocean bottom must have been torn up. Looks like they're a pretty hard hit.
Yeah.
Hi. Is there a harbor master we can talk to?
How do you end with an ish?
Gaelic, huh?
Doesn't sound like welcome in any language.
Hey, kid. Is your father at home?
I don't have a father.
Oh. Well, does the harbor master live here?
It's the right place you come to, then. Come in.
say the harbor master lives here?
Yes, but it's a city man he is. A government man.
Well, who is he? What's he do?
Forgotten's his name. Calls himself an archaeologist.
What's your name?
Sean. I work for him.
Doing what?
Well, bits of this and bits of that. Cleaning up the things he finds.
What things?
You want to see them then?
Yeah, sure. Viking, looks like. Yeah?
That's it. There was a great sea battle right off the bay here, and we Irish drove them off and sank their ships.
What's that?
That's Ogre, the sea spirit.
Just groundwork he did that day.
Sounds like St. Patrick and the snakes.
What are you doing here? You get out.
I'm Joe Ryan. My partner, Sam Slade.
Hi.
McCartan's the name. Salvage vessel, aren't you?
Yeah.
I thought so. Did the boy tell you about all this?
Yeah, a little.
This stuff has no real value, except to us eggheads. But since it turned up, no ship's allowed at Narra Island for more than 24 hours without a permit.
Well, look, Fred, we're not seaworthy. We won't be for 3 or 4 days.
I don't make the artist. That's the way it is.
Anyway, we're afloat. Come on, Sam. Hey, how about fresh water?
We'll give you that.
Thanks.
No hard feelings now.
Oh, no. You believe him? Not his permit?
No.
Well, something's eating him. I wonder what. I don't know. Come on. Maybe we'll swing a little more weight around here if we find out.
Hey, Joe! Look! Slag her off, Harry. Are you having any luck?
You know, Joe, they can talk English every bit as good as you and I can. They just don't want to, that's all. You try him, Harry. He said there's no time for talking with strangers, and McCartan does all the talking on the island.
Cody!
Two of the divers didn't come up, Joe. They think they're gone.
Gone? There's one.
Call Wilshire. Are they in with the mission?
What's worrying McCartan? He's dead.
Dead, how? Huh?
You saw him come up. You asked me, he died of fright.
This is crazy. There was a man lost down there today, not even a trace. Another one saw something that scared him to death.
Look, Sam, you don't want to go? Don't go.
I'm going, all right. Just to make sure that you get back.
Sure. With a hat full of gold. Get set.
Yeah, okay. I don't know. But whatever it was, I never want to see it again.
How goes it, Sam?
These are the last few barrels coming on board now.
Lock you back, kid. Where?
Well, Cotton wants to see you. It's a fine rig, you said.
Oh, it is it? Look, kid, get down off there, will you?
About the permit.
What about the permit?
It's a heathen lie.
Maybe we better see what this joke has got in mind. Where is he?
Come on, then.
Harry. What's going on here?
They think a shark got the man who was lost.
Mr. McCartan, I hear you've got a beef.
You were snooping around out there. My divers told me.
Yeah, and I suppose they told you to give us all that jazz about a permit.
Are you doubting my word?
You're right, Mr. McCartan, I am.
After you load with water, you leave. Tonight.
The sooner the better.
How do you end with the niche?
Thank you.
There's a man. Looks like he's got a real problem.
Uh-huh. Now, then he'd pay through the nose if he could solve it for him.
Hey, mister. We'll be wanting a passage on your ship just as soon as his lips here gets around to giving us our pay.
Now, hold on. You'll get your pay if you like. There'll be no taking a passage on any ship.
Why not?
Now, for God's sake, let's go inside and talk about it.
Sure.
If they all leave now, my boatmen, my divers, the lot of them, the whole thing will go to smash.
Me? I kind of see their point. Got any other reason for not wanting them to leave?
What do you mean?
Oh, like, maybe they talk too much.
Where did you get those?
Same place as you. Supposing we got rid of that thing for you.
The beast? Do you think you can?
Maybe. Let's take another look in there first, huh? Open the safe.
For yourself.
How about this for a down payment? Do you like this one, Sam?
You must be out of your mind. A thing like that's priceless. And how do you think you're going to dispose of it?
Oh, you must have figured out a way. I'll bet we can.
You dirty blackmail!
Shut up!
You're getting off easy, friend. Could have grabbed the lot.
When will you start?
Now. Why not? What is it, kid?
You'll be trying to catch him, Ogre.
Yeah, maybe. Not afraid, are you?
No, but it's a bad thing you're doing. A terrible bad thing, Mr. Ryan.
Why don't you call me Joe?
Okay, Joe.
Okay, Sean.
We might be able to catch him in the nets.
Yeah.
But how do you propose to kill a thing like that?
Oh, I don't know. Dynamite, maybe.
Ever stop to think what a thing like that might be worth alive?
You really think you'll catch him with that?
Sure, why not? I figure that the lights will act as a sort of lure.
If that doesn't work, we'll try something else.
Okay, Harry, come on.
Okay.
Johnny, what?
Ready when you are, Joe.
Okay.
Take her out! Take her out! Out! Lower her away! Down!
Sam, can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you.
Give me about 15 fathoms.
Down!
Sam? Sam?
10 fathoms, how's that?
Okay, that'll do. Give me 4 to 5 knots. Yeah, slow engine, headed down the bay.
Slow engine! Can you hear me? Stop engines!
Stop engines!
Yeah, Sam, not too fast. I don't want to lose them.
Slow up. Up, up.
Anymore. She'll snap the cable.
Drop your nets! Drop your nets!
Drop the nets!
All hands on nets.
Hurry up.
Witchcraft, take it up.
Sam, nets!
Drop it.
Drop it.
Headlines of the entire world are being monopolized by the news of the capture of a fantastic monster, seemingly of prehistoric origin, off the coast of Ireland. Puzzled scientists are already speculating that the monster may have been released from some vast suboceanic cavern far beneath the Earth's crust by unprecedented volcanic eruptions which occurred in the area last week.
Some scientific authorities are suggesting that the whole thing is merely an elaborate Irish hoax. Nevertheless, the Irish government are sending two of their top paleontologists to claim the creature for Ireland, if it does exist.
There's your friend, Professor.
Tell my partner you're here.
Radio, Skipper. Well, those two professors from Dublin have just come on board.
Show them up.
Amazing. I wonder if you realize, Captain Round, the enormous scientific value of this discovery.
I think we do, Professor.
Well, then, I shall wireless the University of Dublin once to make preparations to receive the animal.
I see.
You will proceed to Dublin, and... Well, you'll be properly compensated for your services.
Oh, sure, sure.
Well, we'll meet there. Unless you would like one of us to go with you.
Oh, that won't be necessary, Professor.
Oh, there's one thing. The animal's skin should be kept wet with a continuous stream of water.
I see.
This is most important.
Now, I'll take care of it.
When do you intend sailing, Captain?
Tonight, if that's okay by you.
Sooner the better. See you in Dublin.
University of Dublin. Properly compensated. Big deal.
Take a look at this, Sam. It's from Dorking Circus in London. They offer 30,000 against 50% of the gross. Set a course for London, Sam.
To go back to the sea.
You little nuthead.
What do you think you're doing?
Hey, take it easy.
I came to let him go back to the chief where he belongs.
Why?
Maybe to save your silly skins for you.
Well, a good notion to toss you over the side.
You wouldn't be sending me back now.
Harry?
Yes?
Better get our little stowaway into a bunk and wash his face. Harry, put a guard on that thing 24 hours and give him a rifle.
Right now, John.
I could be watching him for you, now.
Yeah, you'd be great, wouldn't you?
Now, if it so much as moves, start shooting and then run like the devil.
Tell us something, kid. Anyone ever see that thing before?
And why should anybody have to see it to know it's there?
Go back to sleep, kid. It's just phosphorus, Sam.
It's coming from the scuppers. It's the water off the animal.
So it's still salt water. You're seeing spirits, too.
Biology, and you turn it into a circus freak. Outrageous. Quite apart from the fact that you stole it.
The fact's a matter of opinion.
What's the row about?
You know absolutely nothing about this animal. It's extremely dangerous.
We've managed to handle it all right so far.
Carry disease-bearing parasites or unknown bacteria. And you bring it into the heart of a great city.
Look, what do you want?
First, the opportunity to make a complete study.
Okay. It doesn't interfere with business.
Believe me, gentlemen, once the animal's installed in Battersea Park, you'll be given every facility. I presume you thought of the need of giving the animal a tranquilizing drug before you transport it? Because if you haven't, you'd better.
Well, I'll lay that on there.
Good day.
In our most unusual telecast to date, we bring you the arrival of Gorgo. This creature, which should have been extinct 10 million years ago, is truly an awesome sight as it is transported through the streets of modern London on its way to Battersea Park. Of course, Londoners are notoriously skeptical, and a good many we've spoken to still seem to think it's all some sort of circus stunt. But this animal is real. Take my word for it. The police have cleared all unauthorized traffic along the route as a precautionary measure. Although we're assured there's no danger, the creature has been given massive doses of tranquilizer. Much closer to this thing, and I could do with a bit of tranquilizer myself. Actually, it's no joke. There are rumors that the animal has killed a number of persons already in the process of its capture. Now you see the circus grounds at Battersea Park and the Festival Gardens, where Gorgo, as he is called, we don't know why, will be exhibited to the public. Here we can see the intrepid Captain Ryan, the one with the cap, getting out of the car with his partner, Mr. Slay. They are the men who captured the animal, and I don't envy them the job. And our own Mr. Dorkin of Dorkin Circus in a checkered suit. And by the way, we'll be interviewing Mr. Dorkin shortly at Battersea Park, so stay with us.
And of course, ladies and gentlemen, I realized at once
that this was the most shattering scientific discovery of the 20th century, and so I contracted for the exhibition of the animal. We've built a special enclosure. You will see it later on. We rushed the job through just so everyone in London would have an opportunity of seeing Gorgo for themselves.
Question? I have a report from Dublin that the Irish government are going to take legal proceedings to recover the animal.
Yes, I believe that to be true. Of course, the matter will have to go through the courts in the usual way. And since I've no way of knowing how quickly they'll reach their decision, I suggest that anyone who wants to see Gorgo does so soon at Battersea Park.
That name Gorgo, does it have any special significance?
But my dear sir, of course. The monster of Greek mythology, the Gorgon. A creature so terrifying that the mere sight of it would turn a man to stone, excuse me.
And how much money do you expect to make out of it?
I'll answer that question later on.
Lower away. Okay, Sam.
Easy does it.
Four.
Tranquilizer seems to be working.
So far.
Okay.
Cut the net, boss.
Although tonight's tale was a British production, it had its premiere in Japan in January of 1961, 9 months ahead of its premiere in Great Britain. The reason was that this was going to be originally filmed in Japan as an homage to Godzilla. But before production began, Producers the King brothers, along with director Gene LaRue, decided to move the location. They first thought about Paris before finally deciding on Ireland and England. According to the film book by Bill Warren, Keep Watching the Skies, Southern Australia was also considered. But supposedly the producers thought no one would care if the monster attacked Australia. Also, the lack of worldwide recognizable landmarks for Gorgo to destroy was also cited as a consideration. The British theater posters and lobby cards all kept the face of Gorgo hidden. The reason was from a line of dialogue in the film spoken by Martin Benson, who plays circus owner Dorkin. When asked why the name Gorgo, he replied, "It's derived from Greek mythology of the Gorgon sisters, whose faces were so frightening, one look would turn you to stone." Gene Simmons, the demon of the band Kiss, a lifelong monster film lover, based the iconic design of his performing boots on Gorgo's head. It's time for tonight's monster question. William Sylvester, who plays Sam Slade, can also be seen in a film where he's battling against a satanic cult of vampires. Can you name that film and his role in it? Your answer awaits after our tale.
Children, very instructive. This way. Hurry, hurry, hurry to see Gorgo. The last remaining link with prehistoric time. Only 5 shillings, ladies and gentlemen. 5 shillings to see Gorgo. There are still a few remaining places. Queuing both sides. Bring the children, very instructive. What's that, madam? Looks like your husband. Go inside and find out. 65-foot-high Gorgo and heavier than 6 elephants. Cream here. Get your ice cream.
Peanuts! Popcorn! Hot-buttered popcorn! Roasted peanuts here!
Goldie!
Peanuts!
Ice Goldie! Coca-Cola!
Peanuts! Popcorn!
Looks like a full house.
Not bad.
Oh,
Hi, Sam.
I was driving into town.
Have fun.
But you might like to come along, have a couple of drinks.
I'm having a couple of drinks. How's business?
Great, great. Why don't you get out of this dump, live a little? I got a suite of rooms at the best hotel in town.
This suits us.
Look, Joe, these animals are going crazy.
Something's gonna happen, I can feel it. Mike's already been killed, who's gonna be next?
I'm as sorry about Mike as you are. It was a tough break, that's all.
But he's got a wife and two kids.
Okay, well, we'll send her some money.
But he's dead. And there's gonna be a lot more tough breaks before this is over.
You've been listening to your new partner too much.
I've been listening to myself. Hello. Yeah, just a moment. It's the professor. Says he's been trying to find you.
This time of night? Hello? Yeah? Yeah, if you say so. Okay. He's found something out. You coming along?
Yeah, sure.
Come in, gentlemen. Captain Ryan, the creature you have captured is not an adult specimen.
You mean it isn't fully grown?
No. In fact, we believe it is in rather early infancy.
Are you trying to say there may be a fully grown one of these things around somewhere?
It's a fair assumption. Where there are offspring, there are generally parents.
How big would a full-grown one be?
An approximate guess. The infant, the adult.
That would make it nearly 200 feet tall.
At the very least.
Obviously, the proper authorities must be notified at once.
What are you trying to do? Stir up a whole hornet's nest because of a few calculations made on a piece of paper? Nuts to that.
I'm afraid, Captain Ryan, the decision is no longer in your hands. I realize the situation is fantastic, but...
One expects the fantastic from you scientists these days.
Tell me, Admiral, have you ever seen the animal that was captured?
I'm afraid I haven't had the time.
Then perhaps you should take the time. And when you do, remember it first appeared at Nara Island.
Monitor reports there's been no communication with Nara Island for 3 days, sir.
3 days?
Her Majesty's aircraft carrier, Royal Oak, from the Admiralty, Whitehall. Proceed to area N34 and report any unusual sightings or conditions in vicinity of Nara Island. This is priority A. Repeat. This is priority A.
Thank you.
reconnaissance to corvette. Alter course to 310. Repeat, course 310.
Right. They've sighted something, sir. Four points.
Port, 4 points.
Aye, aye.
Observation negative. Repeat, negative.
Admiral Brooks.
Gentlemen, you've been asked to come here to supply us with any information in your possession which might be helpful. Nara Island has been destroyed. Reconnaissance aircraft have sighted a creature in this area here.
Excuse me, sir. That looks as though the thing's heading for England.
Quite. And that in itself calls for an explanation. You have one?
Well, we were playing a stream of water on it during the passage. It was Professor Flaherty's instructions. Maybe it left some sort of track.
I see. Is that possible?
Yes, it's possible.
The Royal Oak for Admiral Brooks, please. Royal Oak coming in for Admiral Brooks.
Good. They report at least 2 direct hits.
You killed it?
It's disappeared beneath the sea. They've saturated the area with depth charges. No living thing could escape. It's certainly been killed. Sunk with every man aboard.
This is terrible.
Well, all right, now what?
What will you do?
Turn that thing at the Festival Gardens loose. What else? Take it back to the sea where we still got a chance.
What the hell's the matter with you? This is the 20th century. There must be some way of handling an overgrown animal.
There's no doubt that we can stop the creature. We'll call you if we need you again. Good evening, gentlemen.
Sam.
Following the disaster of this afternoon, the loss of a destroyer with all hands, the Admiralty has deployed
major forces of the NATO fleet off the mouth of the estuary in an attempt to locate and destroy the monster even before it reaches the coastal defenses.
West 2-5. Black to task force. Search 20 degrees west.
For torpedo attack. Course 275, range 1500.
Course 275, sir. Firing depth.
Ready to open fire, sir. Fire one. Fire two.
Attack and target in the search area.
Contact broken. Target moving toward the estuary. Too fast to follow.
Get me submarine control, sector 2-8.
We're just closing the last of the submarine nets now, sir. Yes, sir.
Yes? Yes. One moment. The nets have been torn and the connection was gone.
No, there's nothing further you can do now.
The creature's got through.
Smash the nets.
Get me river patrol.
I'm just out the embankment. About 100 yards away.
I can see the huge beast still advancing.
The second line of defense has been organized, greatly reinforced.
Ready the morning, Charlie! Look like you know. Man your stations! Control lines ready, sir! Open the valve!
Come on, hop to it!
Army headquarters.
The atomic weapons are out of the question in any built-up area. Tanks, of course.
Roll out! Roll out! Off you go!
Attention. This is a special bulletin. Civil defense authorities have declared a state of emergency for all London areas within 3 miles of the River Thames.
Must be kept clear for military and defense personnel. If you are without shelter, go to the nearest underground and stay there. The streets must be kept clear for military and defense personnel.
It's advancing upriver directly towards us. Very good, sir.
While the Army indicates full confidence, they report growing casualties among their forces. We are told that Downing Street is in constant communication with other world capitals where grave concern is expressed.
Call headquarters. Shoot the flares!
Open sight fire! Stand by!
Commence! Fire!
London's oldest landmark smashed like matchwood. Nothing has stopped this beast so far, nothing. Not even point-blank cannon fire.
Here's the Tower Bridge up. Here, the power of this thing is fantastic.
Now, sir. Any estimates as to the time of alert, sir?
No, but stand by.
Evacuated at once. Do not delay. You have no time to remove your belongings. Get out of the area. Proceed in a westerly direction. Thank you.
Piccadilly, the heart of London.
Words can't describe it. There's been nothing like it, not even the worst of the Blitz. This section is complete shambles. People running mad with fear. Broken gas mains, fires everywhere. There's too much smoke.
Piccadilly Circus. There's no way of telling where this thing will turn next. I don't care how important it is, you must interrupt. It's imperative that I speak to the minister at once. Let me know the moment you are. Thanks for coming.
It's undoubtedly heading for Battersea Park, sir. That's the place to stop it.
How much voltage do you estimate would be required for electrocuting this animal?
2 million? 3 million volts? It's only a guess. There's not much precedent to go on, sir.
Quite. Get me Battersea Power Station.
Is he okay? He'll be all right.
For a miracle. The entire electricity of all industrial London has been diverted to the wires surrounding the small animal's enclosure. Will it be enough? Will it be enough to stop the huge beast? Will the miracle be granted? Or will it be yet another of man's puny efforts to oppose this irresistible force of ancient nature?
Hey, Sam.
reading?
4 billion volts and full amperage, sir.
Maybe our prayers have been answered. A great city, overwhelmed, exhausted, lies helpless under the immeasurable power and ferocity of this towering apparition from before the dawn of history. And yet, as though disdaining the pygmies under her feet, she turns back, turns with her young, leaving the prostrate city, leaving the haunts of man, leaving man himself to ponder the proud boast that he alone is Lord of all creation.
We're going back now. Back to the sea.
Boy, when mama says it's time to come home, it's time to come home. Now, let's reveal your answer to tonight's monster question. In what film does William Sylvester star in where he's battling against the satanic cult of vampires? And what is his role in it? It was 1965's Devils of Darkness from Planet Films Productions. He played writer Paul Baxter, trying to destroy an age-old cult led by the vampire Count Sinistre, who was played by Herbert Noel. Fang tells me your tomb is prepared. But before you go slinking off to your own frightmares, let's see what terrors await you here on your next visit to the Haunted Hotel.
Will everyone in the theater hold on firmly to his seat, please?
Hurry, darling. It will work.
Of incredible thing walked beneath that hood. It would be unfair at this time to show you any more of what went on in that laboratory where a man actually dared to play God. So fantastic, words can't begin to describe it. You must see it with your own eyes to believe it. When the fly comes your way.
The fly. Your next Dead Time story. Be sure to make your reservation. And please like The Haunted Hotel on Facebook. Until then, I bid you good night and rest in peace.